Yeah, like I said before, I kind of missed the 1.47 pack I've been playing.
Yeah.
I built me my own little workstation.
How are you enjoying sort of the retro 1.4.7 Minecraft, Berg?
Oh, I've been enjoying it a ton. All the nostalgia.
Yeah. That's cool.
Is there any way we can, not use the minecart?
Well, yeah. I mean, I can set it up with a hopper clock instead. I think that'll probably work a little better.
Yeah, let's try doing that.
The hopper clock? Yeah. And I'll just run a comparator off of each one of the, or, three of the four hoppers.
Yeah, because it's really laggy.
Yeah, I noticed that too when I was over there. It was pretty bad. But it works! Preacher got it all up and working. Credit where credit is due.
I figure since I'm the resident builder, I deserve my own work spot.
Alright. Well, I guess let me just go ahead and get this stream started here. Since it's about that time, in fact, it's like 2 minutes after. According to the chronometer, we're 2 minutes late.
Oh no.
Oh, you might be late. I'm not.
I'm not.
A wizard is never late. It's always on time.
He's there precisely when he means to. I see somebody's been working on roots.
Roots?
A little bit. Just a little bit.
This is Vaygrim's chance. Welcome to Life in the Buffer.
Well, all right. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Vaygrim's Chance Season for Life in the Buffer Live. That's right, we are live. That is, unless you're watching the video on demand, the VOD, the VOD. What do you guys call it? Do you call it VOD? What do you call it, VOD?
Sounds like some sort of sexual disease.
VOD?
I think they have a cream for
it. It's got the VOD.
Oh, no, I got the VODs. okay, well, so you call it, do you say VOD then, or do you just not say it at all?
I just call it a VOD.
You do? Okay.
I type it, but that's about it.
I usually call it a VOD, but now that you just said that, now I can't call it, because now I've got that in my head.
You're welcome.
Yeah, thank you very much for that. So I am here with the dark creature that you just saw run by here, and Fergcraft. He's running around here somewhere. I don't know where he's at. There he is. Fergcraft, emerging from the trees. Hello, Ferg.
Good I'm to see from you, the forest.
I'm from the forest. Yes. He's a kindly elf.
And, Lisa, can I have some more?
We are here on our skyblock base, and we're slowly building up this base. We're actually wow, look at all this. Ferg, I didn't see all that. Wow. Yeah. Is that all you, a big fan thing down there?
Yeah, I built that, and I finished the other shed. I put a roof on it.
Yeah? Wow, I want to check that out. So yeah, so we're here on our skyblock. We're playing Vaygrim's Chance Season 4 as a skyblock. I don't think that Vaygrim had maybe intentionally made it with skyblock in mind, but things, happened, and here we are. We are skyblocking it. And Ferg's workshop. And so, yeah, so we're out here on, this is the Dark Sanctuary. This is our island with Fergcraft and Dark Preacher. I'm going to check this out and see what Ferg made here. I love these doors.
Nothing to see here, move along.
Nice.
You should check out the door on the little shed I built over there.
Is there a purpose to this, oh, this is your storage here. I almost didn't recognize it.
Yeah, that's storage. Since I'm the builder, I figured I'd make myself a nice little spot so I can be out of your guys' hair.
That's pretty cool. I forgot about these multi-storage, storage blocks. That's pretty cool.
I know. I like these.
It's Ferg's cupboard.
And then, is that where he sleeps? The bed is just for looks. He really sleeps in the cupboard.
It's where I hide the bodies.
What's the story with the smeltery in here, Ferg?
I like the tinker's glass, so that's why that's there.
Oh, okay. So that's just here so you can make your own private store of Tinker's Glass.
Yeah.
I
figured we weren't using it anyway. I might as well use it.
The ultra-clear glass, yeah. It is kind of cool. I do like that very, very clear glass. Except for sometimes the frame doesn't work out in my construction.
And it's here.
What's that?
Hey, Ferg, come here.
What do I do now?
Yeah, come here.
Ferg's here.
Oh.
Where'd you guys go?
Yeah, I know about the elevator.
Oh, yeah, the elevator.
The elevator.
That's another dark creature creation.
Elevator, go down the hole.
We should have three settings on here. Top, bottom, and void. Opens up and drops you out.
I can set that up.
Because if we got any visitors and they came by, surely they'd have to press that button just to see what would happen.
Actually, I would name it top, bottom, and purple because ice cream has no bones and see what happens when they push the button.
Why not just have it say ice cream?
Ice cream.
Free ice cream?
Top, bottom, and just ice cream.
And then, Ferg, you had added a little bit more over here to the mechanism area, too. I like the sound of that.
Yeah, I did.
Empty trash can sound as you open and close the door. And the reason I know that is because...
It matches the build, too.
It does. It really does. It looks really good. The reason I know that you had changed things is because I logged out right about here. Yeah. And when I logged back in, it's like, what has happened?
There has been stuff. I decided to add some yellow windows.
Yeah, stuff and things. No, the yellow windows work really well. They go along with the the caution tape on the floor here.
Oh, and they kind of come pop out with the reds and stuff in here. So
yeah, well, and the little caution checker on the mechanism machines as well.
Oh yeah.
By the way, I don't know if you noticed, but I swapped out our mechanism triplicator. I swapped out the machines for factories, so we can get more throughput.
More goodies.
More things, yeah, more things.
More stuff, more tangs.
Yeah, the stuff was getting kind of clogged up, waiting for things to process.
Because
the basic triplicator could only have one, one ore stream going at a time. So it's getting all backed up. Not anymore. I'm going to have to try out the elevator. I'm going to push the ice cream button here. You really need to do that, Peter.
Oh, all I need is some phantom breakers. And phantom placers.
Yep. Now on the I see you turned the resource center back on again. When I popped in earlier, it was off.
Well, the big tinker tank over here was completely empty.
Yes.
So I refilled it using the drums.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I noticed that too. I thought that we were just going to burn through the last of our oil and then switch over to crystallized. So I didn't touch it. But that was not the plan.
Well, Tinker Tank is going to the generator, is it not?
It is right now, but I thought we were going to cut over and move the crystallized through there. Oh, it looks like you did. I'm looking at it now. So yeah, that's fine.
It's set up that way.
Yeah. Oh, that's what I thought the plan was, is that we would just burn through that oil that was left and then move the crystallized through. So. Nice. So what do you think about maybe upgrading to the empowered foil, or do you have something else in mind for tonight?
Well, the empowered oil is going to take a bit more thinking on how to automate that.
How so? Isn't it basically just the same thing we just did with the crystallized oil?
Yeah, but we gotta add in the power.
Okay. Well, I'm going to put together a little hopper clock here.
Okay.
Right now, the system doesn't work to make crystallized oil because you pulled out the minecart clock, right?
Yep.
Okay, Smokey.
And how very odd. Our purifying factory isn't working.
Well, I'm on my way.
Also, if you look in the system, all the textures are broken, so you stick them in your inventory.
The purifying factory? Oh, yeah. We just got an osmium block there, just sitting there, not doing anything.
Not doing anything.
It's got power. It's got,
doesn't osmium have to go to the osmium one?
Blue.
I do believe we're missing some recipes in JEF.
Yeah, it's all a matter of how to search for them.
Let's see, those should go to the crusher. And that is set for input on. That's odd. All the configurations look fine.
Yeah, all the configurations are fine, but the recipes are missing from JEI. I think part of the mind tweaker scripts didn't get added to the server.
Well, but in the purifying factory, all of these should work. Copper and certainly osmium. Those should work. They shouldn't need any new recipes for that.
Yeah, but if you mouse over it and hit U, all it shows is the smelting, and that only shows regular furnace, extra utilities furnace, smelter, and it's all for one dust to one ingot.
Interesting.
Yeah.
All right, interesting.
Well, it was working, but then again, that was the previous version of the pack. Because after you logged off last time, which I guess was actually about 2 weeks ago now, I went back and swapped this out mid factories, and I sat here and watched it work. So I know it was working at that point, but that was the 1.3 version of the pack. So we may have an issue. Although let me just reset this and see if maybe that fixes something. But to do that, I'm gonna need to. Let's check this out. So we're gonna say disable. We're gonna unplug that. We're gonna pull these out so it doesn't keep feeding. Pull that out. And then... All right, so there's the purifying factory. Now, if I plop that back in, there's my oxygen and there's my power. Curiouser and curiouser. So I wonder if we have any just regular ore I can put in there. Just as a test.
You probably have to make it.
Isn't that funny? Nope, we don't have any ore. Can I craft it? In a mechanism combiner, I can actually craft ore just so I could do a test. That's not bass awkward. I don't know what is. I'm surprised we don't have any ore at all.
Yeah, all we're getting is the X and the pilo.
Mm-hmm.
I hear a skelly. Do you hear a skelly? I hear a skelly.
There was a... Actually, I placed a couple of torches around last time, too, after you logged off, because there were a couple of spots that were dark around here, about in this area especially. I would check the new Ferg construction area, see if there's any bad spots over there. Alright, so I guess...
all it up. Except over here.
Any other way to make ore? Just the combiner, I guess. Do you know of any other way to make ore other than the mechanism combiner? That's it. That's all that JEI comes up with, anyway. That's all that all of the only way I can think of, too. Actual, like, you know, vanilla style ore, right?
Yep.
Alright. Now let's make a combiner then. Googly moogly. That's a lot of stuff to make. That's a lot of stuff. You know what? I'm just going to magic some just for the purpose of testing here, because it's the combiner is all of these elite control circuits and reinforced alloys and all kinds of stuff that I just don't want to go through. Just, oh, okay. Ferg, what are you doing? I'm like, what is this skeleton? Oh my gosh, I'm getting my face bashed in. And it's like, wait a minute. He's not bashing my face. What in the world is going on here? Ferg, you loon.
I found something.
You bony loon. Okay, I'm just gonna magic up some ore here. And if I say search items, I'm gonna say
what'd you find,
iron ore.
I found out how to turn myself into a skeleton.
Oh, that's why I kept hearing skeleton noises.
You were hearing Ferg noises.
I was roaming around looking for places that were dark, looking for a skeleton to kill.
He was like a skeleton troll is what he was. Trolling us all. You were hearing him and he was in my face. I thought, oh, for sure I was going to get caught in inventory mode. That skeleton with the diamond sword is going to slash my face.
Well, technically it's osmium.
Is that what it is? Okay. Okay, so I put iron ore in the purifying factory, and it processes just fine. So okay. There's something with the... It doesn't like the ore dusts. No. So something changed with 1.4. Ooh, what is that? I
reloaded the scripts.
Okay. There you go. So that's it. So there's an error in there. So we're not getting our scripts. Because the custom script isn't loading.
Oh, it's the Moonstone script, but that's no longer necessary because Extra Utilities added a recipe for Moonstones.
Yeah, but correct me if I'm wrong, but I think on that custom script, that if there's an error anywhere, then none of it loads, right?
No, it'll still load.
Really? Okay.
Yeah. It just won't load that certain script.
Yeah. Well, but I'm guessing that's what's going on with our mechanism factory right now, is that something happened to change. I'm guessing it's those scripts. All right, someone call tech support.
All right, anybody got Trunks' number? Oh, wait, speaking of tech support.
Yeah.
You're the new tech director.
Oh, man. You know, someone must have known that when they messed this up. I know, let's just let Greylock fix it.
Yeah, Greylock can fix it. Because, you know, he's the tech director for the League of Ordinary Gamers now.
Ha ha. Alright, well, I'm going to play for a couple hours before I do my duty. But we're fine with the resources we have. I don't think we're in any dire straits or anything.
No, but we're pretty close to a dire derp at this point.
Yeah, just looking at ores. Gonna look at ignits, for example.
I'm gonna go see how the bowl of moon is doing. Oh, hey, wait a minute. There's a dark spot up here.
Yeah, we're pretty well set. So we'll fix. I'll fix that after we're done with the stream. I'll take a look at that and see what's going on. So for now, I'm gonna make us a hopper clock. Is what I'm gonna do. Yay for hoppers.
Less laggy.
I hope so. That's actually what I use in one of my worlds to automate the Tinker's smeltery. You know, to send a redstone signal to the faucet or the drain, you know, is I put a hopper clock on top of the smeltery. It works pretty well.
Okay, how do I make these face up? I forgot.
So, 4 times 5 is 20. What are you working on, Berg?
I'm just trying to automate my smeltery for glass. Forget how to make them go up the drawers.
You having problems with your drawers, are you?
Always. That's besides the point. I thought we could make them go. That's fine. I'll make it work. I'll make it work.
Make it work. Okay, well, I just accidentally made 38 hoppers. So anyone need any hoppers?
No, I made the one eventually. I needed.
We got plenty now, that's for sure. Just thinking of the future.
Is that what that was?
I'm going to throw away all right. My magicked iron ore here. I'm going to need that. I'm going to need 3 comparators. So I'm going to need... I suppose the only comparators made.
Nope.
Hey. Underground.
One, 2, 3. I think each one is 3. Oh, didn't get enough. All right, so we got a bunch of those. Let's take a look at comparator here. Stone.
What kind of stone?
A rolling stone.
Gathers no moss.
That's what I've heard.
Lazy stone.
Righty.
Alright. Help, help, I'm trapped. I've trapped myself. Whatever shall I do? Oh, here, I'll go around.
I still take an FPS hit when I come over here to the boiler area.
I'll just blind creature.
That might be the redstone block over there.
Yeah, it's either that or it's the tree farm upstairs. It might have been fired up when I walked over here.
Might have been.
Okay, let's see. One of those, take one of these. Comparadores. And I should turn off my lucky coin here, I guess. Although we're not really operating, are we? Alright.
That's the prettiest thing in the world, but it'll work.
To be so far away from the machinery over here?
I had it for the minecart, in fact, it was quite wide.
Oh, okay.
I had each of the inputs separated by one, so that way they would get cross-connected.
Yeah. All right, I'm just gonna move it. Just move it over here to your right. Oops. I'm gonna pop a hole in the floor. Very dangerous atomic disassembler.
Yeah, I'm still sad I lost mine.
I should turn mine down to slow. I'm not popping any more holes in the floor. Wherein I will fall through, but most assuredly.
Have the auto chisel? That's fun.
Auto chisel?
The auto chisel.
How about the eye chisel?
That sounds painful.
No, it's what? Like the iPad, the iPod, the iCloud.
Eye chisel.
Just like regular chisel.
But it's for eye. So we're going clockwise, so we'll make this red, green, blue. I think blue. So that is going to be green, and this will be blue. And I need some more redstonium. Redstonium conduits.
Your story, tell it how you want, Steve. There's somebody looking in my stuff.
Hey.
I ain't got nothing you need. My chisel broke. I am now a sad panda.
I was just seeing what that sudden growth on the bottom of your box was.
Oh, sounds like a personal problem.
Yeah, that was just so I could access that because it won't face up.
You know, item conduits work better.
Oh, no. No,
somebody,
how much I like...
Somebody's
I like
still
overcomplicating.
In 1-4-7
mode. Just a smidge. Although these hoppers work a lot better than the 1.47 ones.
You know, I have an idea. I don't know how good of an idea it is, but I have an idea.
But it is an idea.
Anyone else got a? Anyone else have fear in their hearts now?
I'm sorry. What was your idea, Preacher?
Make a whole bunch of rails and then have a rail system go out to the village and then just spiral down through the village.
Hey, that would be cool. Yeah.
Yeah, might be able to get the honor rail achievement with that.
What is that achievement?
Travel 1,000 blocks by rail cart.
1,000 blocks. Okay. Okay, so, help me out here with the sequence here, Mr. Dark Preacher, sir.
Yeah.
Which, fires first, second, and third?
Alright, hang on a second. Is making a hostile working environment.
I'm only doing one side at a time.
You need to file a complaint.
Okay, green, and then brown, and then blue.
Oh, so you've already got them color-coded. So green, brown, blue. Okay.
Yes.
I can do that. Green, he says, and then brown. And then blue. Okay. So... we should be pretty much good to go.
We're not being possible anyway.
Are we powered up so that we can actually do some testing here?
Should be.
Yeah, alright. I will throw the switch. Stand
Except
back.
For some reason.
But, what?
We have nothing in our precision drop.
That sounds imprecise.
There's a surprise.
Imprecise, but not a surprise. too loud. I'm gonna turn it down. There's actually nobody in the stream right now to tell me that the music is too loud.
How dare they?
Yeah.
How dare they?
Good spell.
You and grabbing torches.
Turn that down just a little bit.
Oh, fixing my hostel.
What's that?
Well, it's all set up to pull everything out of here. It's just not.
Oh no, more strange things. Okay.
I didn't touch it. I got video proof. All I did was build my box and finish the shed and build some stuff.
And things stopped working.
I was left alone for an inconspicuous amount of time.
Ooh, hello, bump the mouse. So what do you think, DP?
Eh?
What's going on?
I have no clue.
It's right. Broke.
That's what I'm thinking.
Well?
And also, is the timer running?
No, I have it off. I didn't turn it on because you said that there wasn't any supplies there.
Well, I have supplied the precision dropper.
Okay.
The fluid placer is getting fluid like it's supposed to.
Yep.
And the fluid collector is ready and standing by, completely empty. So.
All right. Well, I will throw the switch.
Pull the lever, Kronk.
All right.
Wrong lever.
We are clocking.
Figure if I put walls, that'll help it. Can't see it, so.
Is it doing anything? I'm not seeing anything.
Bigger hammer.
I mean, we're getting a lot of cave noises, but
you're welcome.
Our fluid placer isn't placing. Purchasing dropper isn't dropping.
Well, at least
you
it's
might
consistent.
Have to break. We might have to break and replace every single inter-IO cable.
Okay, well, let's try that. So, the green is... it should be clocking here. So let's just try that. Let's find... here's our green, which is our fluid placer.
The redstone conduits. I mean, we might have to break and replace all of them.
Yeah, yeah. So, let me do a simple one here. We'll start with the... actually, the fluid collector is probably the bad place to go. Let's start off with... Let me start with the fluid...
Oh, that could explain the lag, too, if they're acting up again.
Alright, so you just replaced the green redstone conduit, right?
Yep.
It's set for strong signal, and there's no fluid being placed, obviously. Let's do this. Let's just make ourselves a really quick lever.
And I have lost sound.
Sound?
Or is there a sound muffler? Oh. Is there a sound? That's why. I'm by the sound muffler.
So if I just
do
this
know there was...
manually. Did we get the fluid placement?
Fluid placement is placed.
Okay. So then it's not picking up the signal from this comparator. Is the thing. Yeah. Right, because if I flip the switch, then we see the redstone conduit go hot.
All right. Brown's not doing anything. I might try replacing.
Well, I don't think that it's a problem with the machine. I think the problem's over here, in that it's not, the redstone conduit isn't picking up the signal from the comparator, is the problem.
Probably.
Yeah, that's it. Because when I replace the. When I just put a lever over here, then it picks it up just fine.
Vanilla redstone it!
That's what I'm gonna do. Still, it doesn't even pick up the vanilla redstone either.
Is it set right?
Let's do this. Let me just remove this. That didn't help either. Okay, so that's flipping. Maybe it's not... The signal coming out of the comparator maybe isn't strong enough to go through the conduit, because it comes out at like a 1 or something like that. So maybe that's the case. It's just not strong enough to turn the conduit on.
Could be.
That's why there's a little thing called strong signal.
And it's really disconcerting placing blocks next to a sound muffler.
Oh, you place them and there's no sound.
There's no sound! I don't know what's wrong! Well, the fluid placer's working proper.
It is right now, it is? Are you watching it place fluid and then remove fluid? It's not placing fluid. Yeah.
I had to build it.
All right. Well, I can fix it though. I think since I know what's going on here, I'm sure that's it. It's just not a high enough, strong enough signal.
I'm just dumping stuff into the void. It's fine.
Yeah, it's fine. We got plenty.
It's fine. Hey, I can safely get out now. Maybe. I finished pulling off our little lag center here. Oh, the lag center.
I may need to move to another comparator, though. Let's just check this out and see if that's really what the problem is here. Yep, that was it. So now let me switch this back to green. Select it. There it goes. That was weird. Okay. So now that I've put that back to green again, where it should be. Alright. Now, is there a slicker way to do this? That's about it, I think. Again, was green. Green, blue, red, is that right?
Green, brown, blue.
Green, brown, blue. Oh, okay. I guess Andrew put it right back again. Well, you switched it.
There I put them back.
Okay.
Greylocks made brown.
Now, Ferg, ain't that your job?
No, that's my medical issue.
Clean up the brown.
Not anymore. Now I'm just the gatherer. I don't know what I've been. They decided I'm doing something else now, I guess.
Is that at work? You've been reassigned?
Yeah, I'm still in the same department. I'm just doing
a crappier
job.
You were working too well, so they had to promote you.
No.
Or
They're demoting me to what I started as.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
My job's horrible. It's not so much your job as your place of employment.
Alright, so the fluid collector, which is blue.
I don't know. It's six of one, half a dozen of another. So much stupidity there, it's unfreaking real.
So it looks like the blue, which is the fluid, what do we call it?
Oh, I see the issue.
You do? All right.
Yep, fluid collector can't pick up any of the empowered because it's got regular oil in it.
Oh, that'll do it.
Ah.
There. Kind of wish there was an easier way to empty that out.
Magic?
Yes, magic.
Well, that should make things better because then when we're offline, it won't be forced to render it, so that's why I just put the solid walls all the way around. Right. Make things a little less laggy.
I heard it go sploosh.
Sploosh.
Are you ready to fire it up?
Alright, let it go.
Let her rip. Nice. It's fluidizing and it's defluidizing.
Yeah, need what? To slow it down a smidgen, though.
Oh, really?
Yeah, what? We might end up with crystallized canola seeds despawning.
Why is that? What step? You said we need to slow it down?
Yeah, just a little bit.
Oh, so the whole clock is too fast.
Yes.
Okay.
Slow it down by, like, maybe, I don't know, a bunch of ticks.
Okay. The so it's the dropper is running too fast, is that what it is?
Yeah.
Alright, and the dropper is on which redstone channel?
Brown.
Brown, he says.
Leave it to brown to be the issue.
Alright. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll just add a few more hoppers to this. You know, we have plenty of hoppers now. And, Ferg, you boxed us in.
What?
Here we go. Yeah. There's a door over here. I just gotten so used to being able to fly around everywhere.
I'm impeding progress. Skill set.
Let me grab the wireless grid here, and we'll pick up some more hoppas. We've only got 34.
Ferg, are you going to make us a special door for over here?
Yes, I'm making it right now.
Actually, I'm gonna take this with me.
I have door. I have made door. I kind of like that sound for this room.
Yeah, well, it's no minecart running around on a track in a circle, but it works.
If I get really ambitious, I'll lock you all in.
All right, so this.
Gonna add in a couple of hoppers, slow it down a little bit.
We're gonna double the number of hoppers that we're gonna do.
Okay.
Bye. It's like a solid state, no moving parts. At least none that you can see.
Hmm.
What? You're humming.
That's a scary sound.
Yeah, I agree.
The real question is I don't know if the blue torch is affecting the brown output.
You think
this thing is still pronounced seeds like it's going out of style?
Well, I can separate them, I suppose. I wondered about them affecting each other too. But I'm watching the redstone torches flicker.
Yeah, it might move the blue over off to the side.
Yeah, I wondered about that. But like I said, they are flickering, so it looks like they should be not influencing each other, but I can move that, I suppose. Yeah, I'll just shift everything down, and I'll put red down here on this corner, and I'll put blue over here, and that way we'll have more separation between them.
Yeah.
All right.
Actually, there is no red. There is green, and there is brown, and there is blue.
There's no red? Oh, sorry.
No.
All right, you're right. Okay. No problem, I'll just redo everything.
Good for you.
It's a character building experience.
There we
go. Do that, and... Oh, I'm low on conduits.
Oh no!
Yeah, I'm getting a couple more conduits. Alright, I'll go make me some redstone conduits. Hoping we have all the bits and pieces. Okay, redstone conduits. There's insulated redstone. Looks like I should have it all. I'm missing everything. No conduit binder, no redstone alloy, none of the above. I can't work this way, people.
Cough noogies. Oh, hello. That's not a good spot.
What'd you find?
Some red. That shouldn't be red.
Okay, I've got some redstone on me. Find us some silicon. I'm typing. I'm here. Drop that over here in the smelter of alloy. And let's see. Binder. And in the darkness, binder. Let's craft some more, shall we? Okay.
Why does that make me nervous?
What's that? You gonna craft a couple more rings? Rings of power? Don't worry, they're innocent enough.
Your story, tell it how you want to.
Still need to hook up farm to down here, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
Get the canola seeds out?
Yeah, we're not moving canola seeds from the farm downstairs yet. H should be enough now. So are any of you biting on the new Mass Effect?
Talk to me.
Are any of you playing
Mass
new...
Effect Andromeda?
Yeah.
No.
That requires money I don't have.
You cannot afford to get it until Thursday, and then the wife is going to be monopolizing that game.
I see.
That does not surprise me.
Very
at
kind
all.
Of you to be to let me do that.
There ain't no stopping a BioWare fangirl.
Yeah.
Well,
if she wants Mass Effect Andromeda, she's getting Mass Effect Andromeda.
Girl gets Mass Effect Andromeda.
I mean, come on, her username is Lyrium Biotic.
That's true. True enough. Brown. Blue, green, brown.
Are we still making lava?
I don't think we need to make lava.
Why no, we're not making lava.
Okay.
Are you wanting lava?
No, I'm just gonna steal from the tank in there.
Ah. You were wanting to steal lava.
Well, I need it for my smeltery.
I need it for my smeltery. I need glass.
I need it for the children.
I need the pickies. Hey, sir, can I have some more? Try to settle down. Try to worry less.
It's when we face the eye. I hold you in my chest. So I can happily make my glass. That I won't be able to use, though, because I have ideas for it. I just need lots of it.
I need lots of glass.
Lots of it.
Okay, everybody, Greater C is here. The party can start now.
Woo!
Woo!
Party!
Hey, Greater C, thanks for joining the party here. How are you tonight? Just had the meme. Oh, the memeiest D&D session ever. Oh no, do tell.
All the memes.
Yes. All the D&D memes.
Well, I'd like the dog one I found. It was on Twitter.
Oh yeah, that actually was pretty funny.
I got it from somebody. It might have been Greater C that reposted it. It looks awesome. Let's see. What was I doing something?
And brain.
If you give me a nice.
Someone started playing the Escape from the City song from Sonic. Alright. Gigantic baby yaks almost ran us down, but got distracted by a thrown lasso. Alright, wait to see where this goes here. Run out of stone conduit again. Okay, more redstone conduits. Why is that showing up there? Oh, because I don't have any, that's why. That, but this. No, not that, but this. Is that more for that? Yes, I do.
Yeah, I have a tool rack now.
Okay, so Greater C, I'm not sure that I follow you. Gigantic baby yaks almost ran us down, but got distracted by a thrown lasso. Yeah, I'm not falling. Nope. Just not happening. You still there, Dark Preacher?
Yeah, I'm still trying to figure out why this conduit isn't pointing anything.
Alright. No, that's fine. Awesome. You just got quiet all of a sudden there. Okay, yeah, right, okay.
going to make my life
gigantic, baby yaks.
There
that is some
go.
Crazy
now
campaign
working.
You got going there. So you you got it pulling down?
Yeah.
Cool.
It's pulling.
Looks like we got some extra seeds dropped in there. The seed dropper is brown. So let's swap this. Make this one brown instead. I'll make that one green. No, we'll do brown last. No, let's try that. Let's make this one green. And we'll do this one brown. See if that works any better. Oops, I'm gonna do that. The picker upper is blue. All right, so. Wait a little bit. So yeah, greater sea. So we got rid of the minecart clock, and instead we're doing a hopper clock here. And now we're just messing with the timing to get it right, so we don't end up having stuff wasted here. Green. So I really want to do green, brown, blue is really what I want to do. Which I think was the way it was to begin with. Game sounds are really a little bit louder than my voice. Oh, really? Oh, you know what? Now that you mention it, yeah, I guess I am hearing Minecraft kind of loud. I didn't really notice that. Music and sounds. Gosh, well, I need to turn that down. How's that? Is that better? I hadn't even really noticed that even in my speakers here, I'm actually hearing the Minecraft noises really loud. I guess it was extra loud just because we're sitting underneath the farm here and it's doing its thing.
Yep. Loud farm is loud.
Loud farm is very loud, yeah. I'm still seeing extra seeds get dropped in there. Sure that that's even blue. I'm not even sure that's picking up. All I see is it going down. I don't see it picking up anymore. What are you working on there, Dark Preacher? Just watching you, your jets burn there.
I am trying to figure out why in the world this thing is not pulling out the canola seeds, but it's pulling out the canola.
Oh.
I'm getting some speed
magical cream. Bunnies.
What's up? Did you need something, creature?
Maybe the conduit needs some speed upgrades.
Oh, okay. So, Greater C, you've been playing this D&D campaign now for, what, about 4 or 5 weeks? Something like that? Is that right? How's that going? Is it still working out pretty well for you guys? Oh, cool. Super fun. Wow. That's awesome. All right, so just picking up.
And there go. A consistent floor across the whole freaking top.
Gunslinger. What kind of crazy campaign are you playing, Greater C? So what were you saying, Fergcraft? Where are you? I don't even know where you're at.
Tap of the world, man. Tap of the world.
Alright, so we should have fluid in here now. Yep, I'll suck up the fluid. Alright. Cool. So now we're starting from scratch. So let's just restart this. Let's see how it's doing.
Alright, I got 6 conduit speed upgrades. Let's see how that works.
So that's a different campaign. I was thinking that didn't seem to make much sense, Greater C. It didn't seem to fit with what you had described before. Alright, so that doesn't seem like it's picking up. That's blue. It's picking up. Why is that not picking up? Crystallized oil. If I do this, then it picks up, right? No, it doesn't actually. Oh, that's how it did. So you have what, 2 different campaigns going? Where do you find the time for that?
Getting pulled out the way it's supposed to be.
Nice.
And the farm's not running out of seeds because OPEC fixed that issue.
Oh, good.
A while ago.
Yeah.
Yeah, OPEC fixed that issue like 6 versions ago.
Oh. All right. So now it's empty. Oh, I see. Well, that's kind of extra confusing that if it's all the same group meeting, you know, 2 different campaigns. I would think so. That's the green dropper, which is fluid in. Oh, because it's being... Oh, that's why I didn't want to do that. That's why.
Still getting some major FPS hits over here, though.
Yeah, I get a little bit of lag, too.
I think I know why, though.
Yeah?
Yeah, and it's a fairly easy fix.
Oh, I like easy fixes.
You got a lever on you?
I can make one really quick.
Make one really quick, stick it down right here, and then whatever connects to it, switch to like the black channel or something.
Put it down right here?
Yeah.
What is it connected to?
I connect to this thing. Just sit on the floor and connect.
To the black channel? What's the black channel?
Nothing. Because once it's activated, it lights up the entire redstone conduit.
Okay.
And no more flickering. We get to save a little bit of FPS.
Oh, gotcha. So it's flickering. I see what you're doing. Very smart. Very smart indeed. Yeah. All right. So if I look through this, I just picked up somebody's factory block. Somebody lose a factory block?
That'd be Ferg.
All right. So we got oil in there. I'm gonna flip this. And we've got crystallized oil because the seed dropped in. And I flip this. We should have nothing in there because it all got sucked up. Nice! Replace these levers with buttons instead.
Alright, cool. We got a buffer.
Yeah? Nice.
Yep.
Alright, so this should all work. Let's just run through it. So we got... oh, what in the world is this? Okay, that's an accident waiting to happen. You guys see this? Somebody get a hold of Cali. We've got some corruption here in the database.
Ferg, you broke some conduits up there when you replaced the floor.
Oops.
Are you muted, Ferg?
I am. I made a mistake.
I wondered why you were being so quiet up there.
I made a mistake.
Mistakes were made.
I'm sorry.
Hey, Atomic Blom.
Hey, Blom. Bye-bye. I'm breaking stuff.
Blom is breaking. Yes, that's right. Fergcraft is breaking stuff. He's either building things or breaking things. There really is no in-between for Ferg.
Well, technically, I was doing both. I'm multitasking.
How are you doing this morning, Mr. Atomic? There it is. That was a little slow. Corrupt. Oh, did you see those corrupt blocks? What were those blocks, by the way, Ferg?
Those were the item conduits for the tree farm.
Oh.
That had the conduit binders.
Oh, nice.
But, well, they had the conduit covers on there, and I did not realize that at the time.
Alright, let's test that again. So we got that should drop in canola, and it does. And then...
All I wanted to do was make our base uniform and pretty.
I just wanted to make it pretty, and I broke things.
I think you need a painting machine in your room, then.
Yeah, and some power.
Oh, power we can hook you up with.
No, yeah. Not suck it up.
Because I was pretty much the only one using that painter.
Oh, because there's no room for it. That's why.
Yeah. There's no room. It's not going to suck up anything.
Yeah. So when it does that, then it just sits there and it's going to continue to drop seeds in there.
Yep. And at that point, we need a liquid monitor. You shut the whole thing off.
Oh, it's so complicated.
Yeah, it's not that complicated.
It's so complicated. And by the way, I'm Batman.
Nope. And I just realized what time it was.
What?
I'm having so much fun.
Oh,
it's time for me to go.
Fun. Well, did you fix the things you broke first before you go?
No, Preacher's on it.
All right.
You guys know more about what's going on. Besides, he could, like, creatively fix it, so... Oh, I didn't fix it. I didn't realize. I think there's more than one thing I broke.
So, Atomic Bomb, what is this? You concocted a dragon? To leave work early? What does this even mean? Is this an Australian thing?
I will stay in my room until next time, facing the corner.
Well, thanks for all your construction, Ferg.
Ah, not a problem.
You've added a lot. That's pretty cool.
And I broke a lot.
Oh, yeah, but Preacher and I, we can just, like, tinker with, like, four blocks for, like, 2 hours. But you actually, like, make, like, big things.
do you not remember VC3?
Yeah, this is true. That luck.
Are we really surprised I build big things?
Boink, boink, boink. Bouncing around.
Woohoo! Okay. I have 160 glass.
Are you installing a fluid detector there, Mr. Dark Preacher, sir?
Yes, I am.
Yeah, I'm gonna go.
All right. Good night, Ferg. Thanks for joining. Have a good day tomorrow.
Yep. I shall try.
So, Atomic Bomb, you didn't actually concoct a dragon. Because if you didn't, I'm going to just be disappointed.
Alright, we need a... We need basically a main shutoff switch.
For... To shut off the timer?
To turn off the clock.
Okay, there's one... That's this lever that's just right here.
Okay, we just need to assign a color to it. And give it some, Hi!
Oh, hello! Mr. Ender Dude.
Oh, cool. I got that morph.
Oh! Alright. Nice.
But yeah, basically what we need to do is just assign a color.
Yeah.
I set it for orange. Now we just need to get some redstone conduit to turn off the clock.
Well, this lever basically turns off the clock right now. Doing. Yeah.
I know, but we want to have it turn off automatically.
Ah, I see, said the blind man. Okay. We can do that. I've got some redstone conduits here, and you said you set it for orange? Is that correct?
Yep. Yep, I have also got the Tinker Tank, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I think it sets that way it'll, once the Tinker Tank is completely almost all the way full,
yeah,
it'll stop the clock.
Okay.
And it'll stop dropping everything. Oh yeah, that sucker's full.
Well, I wonder... If I do this and set it to a strong output, will it send... Oh, see, no, it's not going to send an output, because it doesn't show it as something like to feed redstone to here. All right. I was hoping I could just drop it down and broadcast that signal right here, but it won't work that way. Oh, was I just missing one? I was just one short. Goof.
No, there's a setting that you can make with the, you got a wrench.
Oh, that's right, you had the wrench with you. Alright, cool. So, let me just, is it turned on now? It's actually, I've got the clock turned off now, so how about I let it fly and we see what happens?
Yep.
Alright, we are clocking. And it stopped.
Yay!
Is that as it should be?
That is as it should be.
Well, now, the fluid collector is not full, so why is it that the clock would stop, then, if the fluid collector is not full?
Because the tank is full.
Oh, the tank is full. Oh, okay. And since the fluid collector... so basically, you put the sensor on the tank and not on the fluid collector. Because
yep.
What happens in the fluid collector is just a symptom of what's going on in the tank.
Yep.
Dragons with brewing stands, yeah. Brewing the dragons. What's that?
Why does the back wall have a zit?
Those are just some blocks that fell down from when Berg was working up there, and I had to do something with them. Is it bothering you?
I cleared it off.
Okay.
Now, I'm going to go move the painting machine and get Berg some power in his room.
Nice. All right, so we've got automated crystallized oil going on here. Got this funky little hopper clock, which actually is probably takes up as much room, if not more room, than the minecart clock did. But we're not seeing the same FPS yet that we were taking with that mine cart clock. And it's automated too, so that's pretty cool. Why is that lit? That doesn't need to be lit. Turn that off. Nice. And then I added buttons to the clock, so if we wanted to manually cycle the clock just for like troubleshooting or whatever, then we could do that. This actually bothers me, this little web of redstone conduit here. Let's do this, shall we? Actually, I need that there. Here. Here. And put that here. And we'll get rid of this. This and this and that. There we go. That looks cooler. I like that. That looks much better, I think. Now, why is this here? So, there is a energy conduit, Dark Preacher, that is coming into the oil room here, but it just kind of stops. Is there some future purpose to that? Or was it maybe something that was being used that's not now, and so I can maybe clean it out? Oh, that's probably power to the tree farm.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And I think it's broken.
And yeah, it's broken. All right.
Actually, I think that was part of the tree farm and the regular farm.
Oh. Gotcha.
That's okay. I'm going to go fix it.
Okay. Yeah, this came out alright. I'm trying to think of a way I could reduce the size of this. That's always the way I work. Lay out something, make it work, and see how small you can make it. I suppose I could double stack the hoppers so they take up less floor space. That could be fun to do sometime. I could have it so it circles once up top and then drops down and circles once on the bottom and then loops up with maybe like a item conduit or something like that. Oh, it's a liquid monitor feeding our orange conduit there. So Dark Preacher, you've got a little bit of redstone sitting out next to the liquid monitor. Can we not just put conduit directly to the liquid monitor, or does it actually need that redstone there?
I'm not sure if the conduit will actually register the liquid monitor and such.
Okay.
But you could try.
Yeah. Stop. Yeah, okay. Alright, so I've got the conduit just directly connected to the fluid monitor, liquid monitor now. There's no redstone, and it appears like the clock has stopped.
Good.
Yeah, that is good. Alright, cool. So many changes, man. We were busy just staring at conduits in there, and Ferg was out here constructing things. It's all totally changed around now. There's no wood floors or cobblestone slab floors. Ah! Found a dark area. And I has no torches. Torque. One torch. Alright, that's all I need, I guess. So, how is everybody doing, chat? It's kind of quiet out there. Are you guys working right now? I think, although, Greater C, you said you just got back, so you're not working. What else we got here? Looks like everything else is good. Cool. Everything else looks like it's pretty well lit up. I'm not sure about this factory block on the floor. It's a little hard on the eyes, in my opinion.
I don't know. It ain't that bad. You get used to it after a bit.
Yeah, okay. After you go blind.
Better than the cobblestone we got down here.
Yeah, well, that's true. Okay, so the canola seeds, or the actual canola, I should say, that's being piped... I can't fly down here. Pipe downstairs now? Where are they being queued up? Oh, here. In the chest. The drawer marked canola. There we go. That's probably it, huh?
Yep. Yeah, where we have 20,000 canola.
Gotcha. So, Greater Sea, you said you're doing a write-up. Do you actually like do a summary of what happened during this session of the campaign? Is that what you do? Sort of like a journal entry kind of a thing, where you keep track of what happened? Blom, you're having trouble getting the stream going in your laptop? Is it, I see you in chat, but is it not load, is the video not loading on your laptop? Gotcha. All right. Well, hey, thanks for popping in, Atomic Blum. Appreciate it. You have a good day.
How fitting, telling an Australian to have a good day.
No, I didn't say that. I didn't say good day. I said good day. I'm sure he gets that a lot.
Oh, you're Australian. Good day, mate. Her.
Alright, I need to get something done here, so... Where are we?
It's okay, he'll be right.
I'm really puzzled about what's going on with the mechanism machine. But there's not really a lot I can do about it from in-game. Did you notice that the elevator had stopped partway?
It had what?
It had stopped partway. The elevator had.
It did?
Yeah. I just hit top again and it went all the way up to the top again, but...
Oh, you were sitting on the drop stop.
Oh, but it wasn't down at the bottom. And it wasn't all the way up the top either.
That's weird.
Yeah, but I don't think it's working now. Maybe it was just a visual thing. Maybe it was just a client server thing, actually. All right. So did you get power over to Fergcraft's room?
Currently working on that.
All right. Do you need anything? Oh, expand on this out. So many changes. Every time I look around a different corner, something has changed. All the platforms have gotten a little bit bigger. So great to see the in-character journal. That's almost like a creative writing exercise then, right? Are you, do you enjoy writing? Majoring in creative writing. Okay, so I guess you do enjoy writing. Awesome. You know, have you ever stopped by at one of Atanchi's creative writing streams? I think he streams on Beam. Well, he streams pretty much just about every day on Beam, but Wednesday, I think, is his creative writing stream. It's actually kind of fun. I don't do a lot of writing, but I don't do a lot of creative writing other than the emails and memos and that. Some of that gets pretty creative, actually. But I do enjoy it. I enjoy the exercise. It's a very intellectual kind of thing. I enjoy the intellectual exercises. You pick up a prompt and try to work with the prompt and work it through. So yeah, I don't know if you've had a chance to look at Itachi's stream, but you might want to check that out. I guess there's a few writing streams on Twitch. I hadn't seen too many on Beam, but Itachi, you know, he's a pretty good streamer anyway, and just enjoyable to listen to. But yeah, he's got a really neat writing stream where it's just kind of pretty chill and sometimes he'll be working through some prompts, and he's got a couple stories that he's working on, and so he'll be working that through with the audience and talking through it. And sometimes they'll go pick up a website somewhere and look at a prompt there, or work through some sort of issue. So yeah, I'd encourage you to check out his stream on Wednesdays. I think is his. Let me just check that really quick. I think it's his. Check his schedule. I think he does his creative writing stream on Wednesdays. Let's check that. Itachi is offline. Oh, he doesn't have a schedule. He changed his page around, but didn't have a schedule on here. Oh, yeah, I'm surprised.
I think we got high ceilings down here.
Why, what are you up to?
Running conduit for Ferg's room.
Oh, right. Alright. Well, let's go check out Ferg's room. Like lost. Okay, where did it? Everything's changed around, so I have a hard time even finding the stairs down now.
And now I can move the painting machine.
Get them all set up in here. So, Greater, so you've got a writing blog that you keep updating, or what's on your blog? Oh, this looks interesting. What's this?
That's where he gets his clear glass.
Storage for his glass, yeah. Very dangerous stair here. Well, that looks out of place.
Yeah, well, so is Fergcraft, so.
No, I was just looking over here at this wall that he put up here. What is that block? That is... Oh, that is... Chiseled stone. I have a personal Tumblr for general stuff and whatever fandoms I'm in at the time. Writing a Tumblr and my in-character journal. Oh, cool. This just feels too big for me.
This, what, Berg's room?
No, the hopper clock. It just feels like there should be a way that we can simplify this. But we don't, you know, without having the triplicator running, we really don't use very much power, do we?
Not really.
IO power monitor says that we're using about 860 RF per tick. Not a lot.
And the generator is using like 2 millibuckets a tick.
Yeah, wow. You as you move.
And if you look at it, it shakes.
Yeah, right. Yeah. That's funny. Now, did you say you were moving the painting machine over to Ferg's room?
Already done. Just go in the door and turn to your left.
Well, that's a mechanism.
Excuse me, turn to your right.
Yeah. All right. So. I actually want to paint it like. I do want to paint it like. I think I want to paint this. A cade. Where is that? Is that this? What's that?
Have you seen what he's got in his tool racks over here? He's got a lava bucket, human eyes, his chicken stick, and his wooden shovel.
These are the signs of a tortured mind.
Yeah, the missing chicken and the Ferg broom. Close your eyes. Seek paradise. Won't change your mind. Shake the lights. I'll take the chance and roll the dice. I want it all. There we go, that matches. He is a creative one. But
yeah, he is. He really is.
Really odd sometimes.
That's his creativity, is what that is. Alright, so now, do we even need this anymore?
Yeah, what?
Oh, just this switch to be able to turn on and off the armor here. Ooh, there's something blowing.
I don't. Because once it gets filled up, it'll shut up on its own.
Yeah, well, it was there to only turn on when the power is actually on, when the generator is actually on.
I don't think we need it for that anymore.
Yeah, I don't think so either. It's just sort of hanging out there now.
So we can ink all this redstone stuff out.
Yeah.
Fill all this in. Pretty it up.
going to use chiseling kind of rigs. I don't think I've got a chisel on me. A bunch of other junk. It's funny, as you get building, all of a sudden your inventory just gets full of just junk. Iron ignits, hoppers, a bunch of ore dusts. Steel? I have no idea why I have a steel ingot in my inventory. Just one, that's all. Just one steel ingot. So, Creator C, you are a creative writing major. What kind of writing do you like to do? I didn't. I totally did not know it. Yeah. Well, poetry is actually... I do enjoy poetry because it is... you got a courtesy laugh, by the way. it's so concise is the thing. In that, you know, it feels like art, and it feels like it is... very loose and free, but really it's very, very concise and I would say restricting. In a sense, it is kind of restricting kind of art.
Unless it's free form.
Well, okay, yeah, but that's the same sort of thing with quote, classical music as well. Some of the neoclassical stuff I don't fancy that stuff either. Sort of the free-form poetry is almost like stream of consciousness kind of literature where it just kind of flows and whatnot. But that's to me, that is a part of the poetry. It is the structure itself and the fact that you're melding artistic flowery flowing speech with this fairly rigid structure at the same time. To me, that's the art, really. That's my opinion. It's just what I think. One man's opinion. Now, which block was this again?
Wow.
What's that?
I just cleaned up a little bit up here. The only thing original from when we first started up here is the furnace, the crafting station, the crafting table, and the two seeds.
There it is, big time. Now, is there anything else we don't need up here? Just check this out. So, we've got all this redstonium here that we don't need, really. Power, conduit, that we all need. Finding odd verse forms. What do you mean? Like, you're talking poetry from other cultures? What do you consider an odd verse form, Greater C?
Like a modified sonnet or something?
I don't know.
On the wee binder?
Cook some binder. Go ahead, craft some more too. those zones of edit since we're out of it. Plus 64. Start. He says, mostly forms from other cultures, but also ones based on math sometimes. Interesting. Yeah, that's kind of neat. I think that's one thing that I like about, again, about the poetry, is that it is kind of a blending of techniques. You've got, you know, a very creative use and sometimes, you know, stretching the meaning of words. But yeah, it's all kind of has to be sort of forced to fit this pattern. And it's interesting, yeah, sort of having to match words with math, because math itself is another language, right? Can you have mathematical poetry? I wonder what that would be like. Math, if math is a language, can you stretch the definition that far to where you have mathematical poetry? What would that look like? Okay, so let's make some facades here. I think I just need one facade. Someone turned an equation into a limerick. If you can get a hold of that, Greater C, I would like to see that, actually. That would be funny. I would like to see that. All right. Dark Preacher. That's funny. You are like a flaming Enderman. It's something from a metal concert. When you rock it up, it looks actually almost like the flames are coming out of your arms and legs. that's great. Yeah, you're like an Ender rocket is what you are. that's pretty good. That is a really funny effect. We need some sort of ornamentation on this big block wall here around the oil room. Not sure what.
Huh.
It just seems too flat.
I think I might have a smidgen of an idea.
Really? Smidge away. What are you thinking?
Chisels and bits.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. Chisel out a channel design,
mm-hmm.
like a 1-bit deep channel around the entire room, and then fill it back in with crystallized oil.
Oh, interesting. So you can chisel fluids.
Yeah.
All right. I actually have not spent too much time with the chisels and bits. It's just I just don't spend that much time doing that sort of thing. Typically, I would use carpenter's blocks, and that's about the fiddliest that I get is carpenter blocks. But I can't imagine chipping away, you know, single pixels of materials to do some sort of decoration. Just not my style. All right, cool. I'll have to check that out. It's actually in there right now. Discord, the TLOG Discord, just posted it, he said. Well, let me just see. A dozen, a gross, and a score, plus 3 times the square root of 4, divided by 7, plus 5 times 11, equals 9 squared and not a bit more. Very nice. Very well done. Oh, that's good. God, that's funny. Thanks for posting that, Greater Seat. I'll have to see if I can't take a snapshot of that and actually edit it into the VOD, the VOD of this episode. Which is a good question, by the way, because I don't think you were in yet, Greater Seat, but earlier on in this stream, I asked the question, do you say VOD or VOD, or do you just avoid the acronym altogether and just say video on demand or something else? How do you usually say it, Creator C? Pick. Yeah, too tedious. Not for people with short attention spans. You usually spell it out, so you're a VOD person. Alright. Well, I usually say that too. VOD just doesn't sound right to me. VOD. Because I think it doesn't actually communicate it very well. Because, you know, VOD sounds like a word. And when I hear VOD, I'm thinking V-A-U-D, VOD. Right? And that doesn't mean anything to me. And so then I think, oh no, that it has to be VOD, like VOD, and it's a video on demand. And so I think it's actually more efficient to just say VOD, because then everyone knows what you're talking about. So I guess it's just it's a communications thing. I'm a communications major, so I guess it's a communications thing to me. So I would say VOD, and then Ferg says, sounds like some sort of venereal disease. Oh man, I got a bad case of the VODs. Yeah, Pog, right, yeah. Yeah. I had actually heard that Elon Musk at SpaceX had actually banned the use of acronyms during meetings. Because more often than not, they actually did not induce communication or didn't encourage communication. They actually obfuscated more than they encouraged communication. And so he banned the use of acronyms. And I can respect that. I think acronyms are way overused. I do a lot of work with people in the United Kingdom, and they seem to really love their acronyms for some reason. And I just, I don't think that they are. They sound like they should be an efficient form of communication, but I really don't think that they are, unless you happen to be within, you know, that one. Small group of people that everyone kind of nods their head, but if you're outside of that group, then it doesn't really work, and so I'm not sure that it's really all that efficient. Still picking, Dark Preacher.
Yeah.
Yep. That there is why I don't really do chisels and bits. If I'm going to pick at something, I'll be picking at a system with pipes and switches and redstone. You know, I kind of, Dark Preacher, I kind of like your idea about the minecart. Oh wait, I just heard a zombie somewhere. Zombie? Yeah, there's a zombie somewhere. Zombie! Where are you? It's over around here somewhere. I'm off on a zombie hunt.
I blame Ferg.
Well, I went looking for dark spots, and I thought I caught them. I must have missed one. It sounded like it was over near the pasture area. No, quiet zombie. Pig! Pig! Hey, pig! Pig, over here! Yeah. Where's the zombie, pig? Pig's not talking. Alright, well, I swear I heard him down here. There he is again. Maybe he's in Ferg's room. Hello? Are there any zombies here? Getting louder. Found you! Boop! Found the zombie. Where is it dark here? I found it! There is one dark spot on top of his multi-storage, his stone multi-storage unit. And the zombie found that one dark spot, as zombies are wont to do. Cool. And it has no sticks. I do have levers, though. Fingers. Fingers type funny things sometimes. What's up? Don't let
the I'm not sure if this looks like the symbol for a power button or not.
Oh, is that what you're doing? That's kind of a cool idea.
Yeah.
We've got enough power, we could be putting electric lights around. Floodlights or whatever. As long as they don't flick on or off, then we don't really get any lag. So you're looking for the universal power symbol, huh? Yeah. I think it's so hard to make a something looks like a circle when you make it that small. What if you were to do it in a 2x2 block instead? Is it not worth the work?
Well, I was going to do a W underneath it and a P above it.
Okay. It's tough to make letters.
Yeah. What do you think?
I think it's difficult to make letters.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Wow, we use so very little oil. Do we have any other lights? The only lights that we have, the only powered lights we have are those floodlights, right?
Should have some powered lights from Ender.io.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, those are kind of cool. I like those. Is just called power. Yeah, they're just powered lights. Yeah, we should start adding those around. So, yeah, I should just make a recipe for those and start adding those around. That's kind of cool. We can start getting rid of some of these torches. And we've already got power conduit running around everywhere, so we can just drop those electric lights, those powered lights, off of the power conduit that's already running around the base. Just in case.
Yeah, well, that'll kind of work.
Oh, I ended up with some chiseled bits of crystallized oil. Did I poach those off of you somehow?
I think you clicked on the tank.
Oh. And it gave you 64 bits.
Well, I think I'm done messing around in here for now.
Yeah.
Yep. You got a little decoration on the back wall back there.
Yeah, cool.
Still got all this cobblestone above us. That's a farm.
Yeah, give one more episode and I bet that cobblestone will be gone. I kind of think I'd like to go see if I can't make this hopper clock 2 stories tall instead of being a 1x or 2x4, make it 2x2x2. I think I might do that. Maybe between episodes do that. Just put it right there. Oh, I need to make inverted ones. That's what I need to do. And I just tossed away that redstone torch. I think if I just make a redstone torch, and the lights are so small. There we go. Make an inverted ones.
Crystal torch?
Yeah. I was just inverting the electric light so they'd stay on. I'm kind of curious how much light these would make. So now if I look at... Oh, yeah. A lot of light. There's no, there's just 2 of those, and there's no dark spots here.
That's cool.
Yeah. Works pretty well.
Well, since we got power conduits running above the catwalks everywhere.
Just about, huh? Yeah, I think I might start replacing those, getting rid of some of these torches. Wow, that really just led to a really large area. Just one of them. I'd forgotten how much area this thing's covered. Cool, I'll have to make some more of those. I'm quite pleased. In fact, we can probably light this whole area over here with just one. Instead of three. Probably light this slow, so I don't break this. Just put one in the middle here. Right there, how does that look? That. Move this. Oh! What did I break? I'm breaking all the things! Oh, nose.
Rot roll.
Yeah. Hey, do you have that Yetta wrench on you? Oh, I was actually taking down that light. Can you, if you've got that wrench on you, can you repair that pipe?
Can I ask if there's a pipe put back?
Oh, I thought you must have grabbed it.
Nope.
Oh man, I must have lost it then. Let's see if we've got any more fluid conduits. Yeah, here we go, got some more. Can you join it?
That's the wrong kind.
Oh, are these pressurized fluids? Oh no, I've got pressurized.
Yeah, pressure.
Oh, those are just...
Those are the regular fluid conduits. We need pressurized fluid conduits.
Yeah. Boop. I didn't have any of those. Actually, I've got one in my hand right now. There's one. It's stuck to the conduit right now. Lost that other one.
And what's the insulated redstone conduit for?
Oh, that was to turn on and off the farmer, but we disconnected that, so I suppose that can go away. So do I need to make another pressurized fluid conduit?
Yep.
Because we're one short now? I think I lost one to the void. Hard to find for the flame trails. It's right here. It's not connected because they're just, you know, it's doing that fluid thing where you can smack it with a wrench to get them to connect.
There we go.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you. Yeah, so this whole area is all lit up by that one electric light.
That's cool.
Yeah, that's really cool. That's pretty efficient. Oh, there's one dark spot here, though. creature. There we go. Moved it one over. Was enough. So was Morph a new addition to the 1.4 pack? That wasn't there before, was it?
Metamorph got added, so that way Vaygrim could test it. That way he could also turn into a chicken whenever he wanted to.
That's his thing. Everyone needs their signature thing. He's turning into a chicken. Alright. This is pretty cool. So, what did we get accomplished today? We got, we changed our clock on our crystallized oil manufacturing system. You added a little safety here so that when we're full, it stops the system, right? So it doesn't try to keep jamming seeds in there nonstop. That's cool. I walked in here with my coin empowered, so now I have full of canola. And we got Fergcraft is rounding out his his Ferg cave. And we've started putting electric lights all over the place. Get rid of some of these torches. Upgrade. Oh yeah. See now look at I took the elevator is downstairs. I thought I'd caught it between floors again. But nope, it was just downstairs. So hopefully next time I'll have figured out what the deal is with our mechanism triplicator. And I think that's a pack issue, I'm guessing.
I'm thinking so.
Yeah. And I know that Vagrum's got a whole platform of mechanism things, I think, over in his island, so he's probably be seeing the same sort of thing. I'm still not sure about this factory block floor. Now, did you say that Lyrium is playing Mass Effect already, or she's going to?
She's going to, when she gets it on Thursday.
On Thursday, gotcha. Cool. So she's going to be nonstop Mass Effect Andromeda at that point.
Yep.
Good for, I know a lot of people having a lot of fun with that game. What else you got going, Dark Preacher?
Not a lot. A little bit of teleporting here, a little bit of teleporting there.
It still is kind of freaky. I did pick up a zombie morph. I guess I could use that, but the Enderman's kind of fun. Yeah, so next time, what do you think? We do a little bit more decorating. And I kind of liked your minecart idea, actually. That was kind of a cool idea.
Yeah, it was.
Maybe we could do that and start working on that, make a little minecart station. I've always been a big minecart fan. Alrighty, well, we're at about the 2-hour mark here in the stream. And I think we've got a lot accomplished. We've got a bunch of automation done. And we've got some cleanup as well. There was a couple of conduits that were sort of orphaned that we ended up cleaning up and optimizing.
At least it didn't crash the server.
Yes, well, that is a thing. At least that was a thing anyway. And fortunately, it's not really a thing anymore. That's good. Although, for a while there, I was kind of holding my breath every time I would have to clear out a conduit, hoping that it wouldn't blow up the server like it did last time. But yeah, it seems to be working pretty well. So that's looking pretty good. If we can just get our resources all fixed, we can have triplicator going again.
Yeah, I think that's just a file we have to fix on the server.
Probably right. And it's not like we're low on resources, so it's not really an emergency kind of situation or anything.
Yeah.
Very cool. Well, good stream. I think lots of progress. It's neat to see the base coming along.
Yep.
All right. Any closing thoughts before we close off the stream here for this evening?
I think next time Ferg needs to finish up the toilet bowl. I mean, he's got the bowl. He just needs the base.
Yeah, put the base on there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is pretty funny. That's total Ferg. Very creative. Very creative, funny idea. And it just fits. It totally works, especially when you get inside and see the mobs swirling down the drain.
Yeah.
Too funny. All right, well, hey, thanks, Dark Preacher. It's been a good stream, and thank you, Fergcraft, even though you're probably asleep by now. But... And thanks to Greater C and Topic Blom for dropping in and chatting with us in the chat room. It's always good to have people over there to chat with while we're building away. So at this point, I think we're going to shut off the stream, and this will immediately be available on video on demand at Beam, that's beam.pro/graylock, and give it a couple of days, and it will be available on YouTube as well. So, thanks very much, and we will catch you very, very soon.